Hi everyone, I'm Bonnie Pan. I run programming at Maker Studios. So happy to see you all, thanks for having us. We are here today to talk to you about something that's very near and dear to my heart called Smartish. And it is a long collaboration with warrior poets, Morgan Spurlock and Jeremy Chilnik, where we look at creators and we put the creator-driven nonfiction at the forefront. And we look at ways to tell stories in a real, honest, and open way. And something that we have in development right now is really focused on telling stories around girls. And as we see the boy audience kind of really find their home in gaming and collaboration and community, girls were really looking for something to kind of latch onto and something real and honest, something that you might ask a sister or a best friend that you're maybe afraid to ask your mom or your dad. And so through collaboration, we came up with some amazing stories that I would like Morgan and Jeremy to come to the stage and help tell you about.
Thank you. First, I want to welcome you all to Sundance. The only thing better than coming to Sundance is getting to come to Sundance on somebody else's dime. So nice round of applause for that. This is an incredible place. This is a magical place. Incredible things happen at Sundance. This is a place where 12 years ago, I came here with a little movie that ended up changing my life forever. I'm here now with my sixth film. As you guys, as Hussein said, you should see a film. If you see one film, you should see the film that we produced called Eagle Huntress that Otto Bell from Courageous directed, which is amazing. This film premieres Sunday morning. That's the one film you should see, nothing else. That's the only one. But today we're here to talk about storytelling. And what I love is while there's this little festival down the hill that's, you know, it does okay and it changes lives, what we're doing here is incredibly important because there is a time and a place for 90-minute stories. There's a time and a place for 60-minute stories, for 30-minute stories, for 10-minute stories. And what you guys have the ability to do is empower the next generation, a new generation, a smarter generation, a connected generation of storytellers in a way that's never been done. And we love working with people like you to make that happen. And we'd love to give you a quick look at one of the shows that we're working on, as we talked about in our brilliant Bonnie Pan guiding light here, told you, focusing on our female slate. Here's a look at our first show called What We Teach Girls.
When I grow up, I want to be a careful woman, a kind woman, and a respectful woman. My education is very important because it will make me what I want to be. My name is Carol. I live in Wikwe, Uganda. In Uganda here, they more respect boys than girls. And they give boys more freedom than girls. Parents or other people, they think that educating a girl child is a wastage of money. I'm proud of my country, but I need to study and I fight for my future. The first time I got my periods, I was worried. I thought that that's the end of my life. Because I saw blood coming out of me. I didn't inform my mom that I'm in periods because I didn't know that it's normal.
Funny enough, when Carol started menstruating, she didn't tell me that, Mom, I'm menstruating. I saw her hiding. So I asked her, what is the problem? She told me, Mom, I've gone in my periods.
At first, actually, I felt ashamed. My mom told me that, don't worry, that's normal. Each and every woman have to go in that stage.
The biggest problem is that when the period I started, some girls, they don't go to schools.
I used to miss school when it's my first time to go in periods, but only educated people can be in a successful life. I have to be ready for everything. I can't miss school.
So I tried to help her, to teach her how to use these reusable pads. And then I've never missed school because of her period.
My mom told me how to be a hygienic. My mother is my main teacher.
I'm sure you are going to learn how to sew or to make it.
The reusable pads make me to feel comfortable, more than free, but comfortable. So now I don't miss school. It's most important for the girls to do not miss school because time does not wait for them. So I teach my girls in my community with my mom.
When I was 15 years old, we didn't have many people talked to us about menstruation. But now they are lucky that they are getting us, helping them.
Katusubire nti abali wano fenna ani agenda atagenda mu nsonga ez'abakyala ngatagendamu naye kansubire nti ejja agendamu banga terikyali ddene fenna wano tukola ki muba kimanyi nti tulwala so bwe tuba tukyogerako fenna tukola ki tetusonyiwala.
Also, we teach them how to use reusable pads to never miss school.
Kano, tight worker shield. Kano kalaini. Okwata kalaini ako kano, nokateka mbuna u pockets. Kuno kupadia nukwino veda ko pockets. Otuteka laina ya fail. Chiteka ako watch. Umalo jiteka ako, uwasiba bune inobunu. Watch. I like to be an inspiration for the young girls. The Ugandan culture teaches us that women only do domestic works. During the past years, they had the myth that a woman can't drive, a woman can't work in an office. Funny, funny things. But now it's different because women, they can work in offices, they can drive a car. A woman can be anything she wants to be. My daughter, she'll be what she wants to be. A woman can be anything. I want all the women of the world to be free like me.
Beautiful, empowering, global storytelling. The incredible thing that we're able to do with Smartish and with what we teach girls is tell these global stories, stories that you normally wouldn't get to see on television or be hard to get made. And with partners like Maker and with you guys, we have the ability to kind of bridge that gap in a way that isn't being done, to reach audiences that normally don't get to see this type of programming and to tell stories that we think are invaluable, especially to a young female audience.
So you said something amazing. We have a whole slate of content. Morgan, I'm wondering if you can talk about how our whole nook of storytelling comes to life in Smartish.
Well, the whole idea behind Smartish, which is what, you know, I am, I'm smart-ish, you know, it's and the goal is how do we make stuff that kind of bridges the gap between something that's smart, like a TED Talk, versus something that is incredibly mainstream, like you would see on traditional media outlets like you know, reality TV. How do we find that bridge gap to start something that's smart but entertaining, smart but funny? And so the goal is through storytellers, and we try to identify people who we feel very much share our DNA. So while a show may be driven, like What We Teach Girls, by a brilliant female storyteller, Corey McKenna, who's our field director and editor on the show, there will be other people who we have on camera that are kind of taking us into these worlds from a unique point of view. There could be somebody who's driving us, telling us how they're pulling back the curtain on a certain world, showing us how things function and how things operate. You know, we have a show called Consider the Source that does exactly that, where we kind of take you through the source of salt, the source of soap, the source of jeans, orange juice, like the things you never think about where they actually come from in a beautifully told kind of narrative nonfiction way. So what we want to do is create something that is, I think, eventful, that is entertaining, but at the same time, well, you'll walk away with a real nugget of conversation to start and hopefully a little bit of smarts, smartish. Yeah.
Amazing. Do you, in terms of how we're telling stories across different platforms and how we're partnering with creators, because while Morgan curates this entire network, he really is Sherpa-ing a world that comes to life where we partner with creators and say, hey, what do you actually care about? What's a story you want to tell? How do we take what you're doing on Instagram and think about how that ties in with a longer narrative? And can we talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, one of the goals for us, and you know, I'm a real believer that no matter who you are in the world, everybody's got one good idea. No matter who you are, everybody's got one good idea for a movie, you got a good idea for a TV show, you got one good idea for a digital series. And part of what we've done is really gone after this amazing group of makers that are on the Maker platform, these people who already have great stories to tell, and saying, what are you passionate about? What are the stories you want to tell? How can we help you do that? And you know, we kind of bring them into Warrior Poets and help them understand how to tell these types of stories in longer form. How do we create that narrative? How do we craft that narrative? And we do it in a way that is incredibly supportive with the Maker Universe and also with the teams that we have at Warrior Poets that gives them the tools they need to be the best storytellers possible. And I think that we've been incredibly fortunate with the people we found. I'll have Jeremy talk about some of the people that are in our first shows, but I think that finding those voices, those authentic voices, and that's a key. You know, we built an entire company on trust and authenticity. You know, people believe in what we do and believe in what I've done as a filmmaker, and we want to find people who kind of share that same common goal, that same common path for telling the truth, for sharing it with the world, and entertaining people at the same time.
Yeah, and two of our hosts and two of the talent that are driving two of our shows, one is called Present Tense with Jillian Rose Reed. She's an amazing talent, and I think this is going to be a great platform for her. She's been on MTV before, she's part of the Disney family, but she came to us and said, I just want to explore the world. I have questions that I want answered. And obviously, that sort of appeal really responds to us, because I think that's a lot of what's in the DNA, and that's what's in Morgan's DNA. And we look around, and we never see that show with a female protagonist really going after that. We never see, you know, we see a lot of Inside Man, but we actually never see Inside Woman for a lot of intents and purposes, however terrible that might have sounded coming out of my mouth. but it's a great opportunity, and when you see her, she just lights up the camera, but it's her inquisitiveness that is going to drive it, and she's going to connect with an audience that has those same questions but isn't represented in, you know, mainstream media. There's another show we're doing which you know, is all about sex education and, you know, body positivity, and Megan Tone, she's amazing. When you see her, it's not what you would expect to see for that type of host of a show. But again, what we're allowed to do is find an authentic story. We give them, you know, enough of a vehicle to go find themselves, but we really find it in the field. We don't have to, you know, belabor it and kill it before we start shooting. We don't have to necessarily worry about where it's going to be, what that first, you know.
We don't have to test a host against a focus group.
Exactly.
Yeah, we can go with what we all believe is the best person to tell those stories.
Right, and the idea always wins out on Smartish, and I think that's the most liberating thing that this type of platform lets us do.
And on the idea front, we also are able to take during the what we're seeing at Maker, which is really unique, is taking production behind the scenes and rolling it across platforms. So we're snapping behind the scenes. We're tweeting out some really fun, silly interviews. We're talking to fans and opening them up. So you kind of get that behind the scenes before the show is even airing, and you start seeing fan art and love kind of coming through. Thank you so much for telling this story. And it helps us shape the creative and develop the narrative and really partner deeply about how the formats are going to live in that digital first environment where we're breaking down that barrier between audience and creator and really bringing it to life.
Yeah, and what we're also doing simultaneously now with production is trying to create programming that can be cross-platform. And not only cross-platform, but global. You saw that we were shooting all around the world. Part of what we want to do is create programming that while can live in a short-form environment, could be 5 minutes, could be 10 minutes, could be 11 minutes, we have the ability to marry them together to then springboard it off to traditional media.
And you really, we talk often about the digital network that we've created with Smartish and bringing in these creators, just as like a final note before you roll your tape.
Sure.
Can you talk a little bit about how that is part of your core and supporting creators and how digital allows you to do that?
Yeah, I mean, going back to kind of the original idea of what Sundance, you know, did for me years ago, like when I came here, I was supported by so many other filmmakers within the community who did so much to give me advice, to prop me up. And I felt like I had an obligation to do that to other filmmakers, to do that to other storytellers. And what Smartish has enabled us to do is find those people, find those voices, find those filmmakers who need a platform and a place to tell stories that we need to hear, that we need to watch. And whether it's for us, whether it's for young girls, whether it's for young boys, we feel like we're giving them a place to tell something that is truly unique and authentic in a way that's never been done before.
All right.
Anything else? Should we let them look at it? Here, that's it.
I can tell everyone's
cool.
excited.
I know. Look how excited they are. You feel it in the room. So here, let's take a look at some of the shows that are going to be coming out this year in Smartish.
I don't mean to be silly, y'all. Please forgive me.
Let's prove that we give a shit.
The city has a permit to dump raw sewage into the river.
So all that water, it's all poop.
Bounce music is definitely an escape for a lot of people.
So we're heading to set right now, and I have no idea what we're about to get into.
This is kind of like the easiest way to get that education and not feel like you're being judged.
Beautiful, beautiful.
To me, sex positivity is about not putting any shame or fear into this thing that is just innately human.
What if I just walk like this the whole time?
I like it.
We're brainwashed into thinking that being part of society means you have to accept that this is the way it has to be. But is that really true?
Come on, let's have some fun, fun, fun. Oh.
What's the blue pill do?
But this beer makes me more of a man.
Today's music gets made the modern way, using a computer to make it sound like every other song.
I can't leave. How do I leave? Where do I go?
We take soil, sun, and water, and we create something.
Like people, maybe we're not so pretty on the outside, but we're beautiful on the inside. It's the same thing with oranges.
That quality of milk turns into the quality of cheese that we have.
To be a woman to me is to feel empowered. You should own that.
People might think that I should have limitations, but I don't think I should have limitations.
I want all the women of the world to be free like me.
I actually think they're more powerful than boys because they're pretty much the leader of the family.
I want to be involved, really involved with social justice.
My daughter? She'll be what she wants to be.
It's a whole new level, man.